One of the most powerful features within NetSupport DNA is the alerting component, providing real-time feedback on any number of conditions for behavior across the network. Let's take a look. You'll see on our main welcome screen, we have a summary providing us with information that there have been 10 alerts within our enterprise in the current month's period. Also, looking on our tree view, you'll see that we have an alert symbol indicating next to the channel department. This visual warning can be toggled on or off using the indicators at the top of the tree view. If we drill down, we can see that this information relates to alerts against this PC, IMVH 540. So at a very high level, NetSupport DNA provides a quick and easy way of visually seeing any alerts that have been triggered across the enterprise. If we select our Alerts tab from the top of the screen on the menu here, you'll see that we enter our alerts mode and we can see that the particular alert triggered against our server is new operators have been added. And we'll discover shortly how we can drill down and view those alerts and apply actions where appropriate. Let's start by the visual feedback that the console provides us. So on our main toolbar, because we've entered the alerts mode, you'll see we have, as with each component, our new dedicated views relating specifically to alerts. And they're broken into two sections. The first section identifies any alerts that we have enabled. In other words, alerts that we've set up and they're actively running and monitoring our systems at the current time. Our alerts raised are any alerts that have been triggered, i.e. the conditions have met those that we've defined and they're now providing us with a visual warning. So from the list of alerts enabled, we can select either console, server or PC, and you'll see we have a summary of alerts that are currently active on the system. Here are some console alerts. We have a long list of server alerts, which we'll cover shortly, and we have some individual PC alerts running. So at this point, let's pause and consider what the distinction is between the different alert types that NetSupport DNA offers. It's probably easiest to work from the bottom up in terms of concepts. So first we have PC alerts. These are alerts that occur on an individual PC or device. Some examples are those running at the current time. So if the disk space on a particular PC falls below a certain threshold, if an application runs on a specific PC, if the number of print jobs that a PC is attempting to print exceed a certain level, each of these can trigger an alert. In other words, they're conditional based on a specific individual unit. Our server alerts, in effect, reflect the larger enterprise or the sum of the parts. So good examples here are where across the network there were access to websites, software distribution packages were successful or failed, PCs were deleted from our enterprise, our overall license limit, the sum of many, exceeded our license ownership, whether it be for NetSupport DNA or software in general, whether installed programs, as indicated, exceed the license limit, and so on. So NetSupport DNA has a concept of individual PC alerts for actions that occur on one specific device, server alerts that reflect the broader enterprise, and finally console alerts that relate to the DNA console itself, our technology and enterprise. So when updates are applied, when new operators are added to the DNA system, when rights are changed, and so on. So all very specific to DNA itself. So with those three layers of alerts, we're able to monitor the system from every angle and ensure we get real-time feedback. So how do we go about setting these alerts and adding them to our list of active console, server, or PC alerts? Well, as always, we go to our component menu and you'll see we have the options for each of the three levels. So let's start with our PC alerts. Selecting the option allows us for our organization, and you can see we have a hierarchy structure as before. We currently have three alerts running. If we want to manage some alerts, we simply select the Manage button. As you'll see here, we have the ability to manage those that are currently allocated or create, from the right-hand side, new alerts. If we select New, you'll see a list is provided to us of potential alerts that we could choose to set and configure. We can select one and then simply apply conditions. So in this case here, let's, for example, look at free space as a percentage. It's one that's currently running. If we select Next, we're able to define our particular requirements. So we want to specify an alert where we're going to test the C drive, and we want the condition to be less than and the amount to be 25%. Perhaps we'll have an alert where the disk space drops below 15%. And you'll see we have an advanced option here. The advanced option allows us to control both the sensitivity of the reading and the frequency. Now, the sensitivity is an important component. If, for example, we were measuring CPU utilization, we might not want to test just once and that be sufficient to trigger an alert. It's quite possible that a PC could have maximum CPU utilization for a short period of time. So for that type of alert, we may choose to set the sensitivity to be test, in this case, 5 concurrent times every 30 seconds, and if the condition is matched, then trigger an alert. In the case of disk space, once the disk space falls below a certain level, it probably does reflect that that disk space will remain low. So in this case, we can set our number of checks to 1 or 2, and we can choose to poll perhaps every 1.5 minutes or so, and then we can say next and apply our alert. The next option is, who are we going to tell when the alert is triggered? Of course, we'll have our on-screen indicators, but we can also choose to alert on-screen specific operators that have been defined within the DNA environment. And if we choose to configure it within the system, and we'll show you shortly, we can also choose to notify individual users by email. Let's say OK, and we'll finish that, and you'll see we now have an extra alert that, if we wish, has been defined and can be added to our categories at the bottom. So for our PC alerts, we now have 2 disk space warnings. We have a print queue having more than 10 jobs, and we also have an alert if the application Notepad is run at any time on our system. And we can simply say OK to that. So now we've got 4 print jobs, and we'll see when we look at our print list, we now have under our PC, here we have our print, free space, and application Notepad running. So with those alerts running, any alerts that are triggered will immediately appear within our hierarchy structure here. And remember, alerts can be assigned against the entire enterprise or against just specific departments. We can drill down again, so we'll see individual PCs if an alert triggers. So we'll wait to see whether any of our alerts trigger in due course. But in the meantime, let's look at our other kinds of alerts. So again, from our alerts menu, we can select our server alerts. And here you'll see we have a list of all of our available alerts. And below, we have our enabled alerts. So for each category, we can specify any alerts. This is those of the remaining that haven't as yet been assigned. We can see, for example, if a CPU changes on the hardware, we can simply select the alert and say add, and it becomes part of our overarching list. We can review the different items we have defined at the moment, perhaps attempt to access a restricted website. And again, we can review that and we can decide on specific information such as its priority, and again, who we'll contact if the alert is triggered. So for our system alerts, it's very easy and simple to select from our predefined list and enable or disable the alerts that we want. We can do the same with our console alerts. And if we select our console alerts, because these relate specific to DNA, you can see under our DNA console, we have alerts that are triggered based on currently enabled, a new DNA operator being deleted, added, configured, and so on. And whilst we're talking to you, you may have seen an alert pop up in this corner, which we'll show you shortly. And at the top, we have some new alerts that we could assign if we wanted to, which is one of the new features in NetSupport DNA, namely our ability to monitor directory accounts and warn us if any accounts become disabled or locked on the network, a good way of ensuring user productivity on the system. Okay, so if we wanted to apply this particular alert to our system, which is to warn us if a directory user account becomes disabled, we can edit the conditions. Here it's a critical alert, and it will alert contact admin within the console. We can choose which domain accounts we want to monitor, in this case all members of UK, and here we'll need to provide our admin credentials to give us the rights to poll the network itself. Once we apply those, we can then test our credentials and then set them. In this case, we'll just hit cancel, as we've already got some alerts running here. And again, when we hit close, that's now running on our system. Now, you remember earlier we listed our PC alerts here, and one of our alerts was, is application Notepad running? And we had a pop-up message appear on the screen. If we look down here, we have a new one on the work group, and we can see for this particular PC, we have an is application Notepad running. We can see the time that it triggered, and we can then look at the conditions, and it says on this machine with this user at this address, the condition was met. So we can now close the alert. We're happy we've seen that. Or we can enter a description. Let's just put that was noted. Thank you very much. And we'll close that alert. So that alert's now cleared off the system. It's a very simple and easy way for us to be alerted to any conditions that change on the enterprise. Now the last bit to also be aware of is if we go to our tools menu and we select our settings, from within our settings, we have an email option here. And this is where we create and set up our credentials linked to our email server if we want to be able to send email messages directly from DNA to specified users when alerts are triggered. So this is where we go to specify the email server address, the account name and passwords that we're going to use, and then we can select the option here to test that it's working so that in future any alerts triggered can be directed to the right individuals. We'll come back to our home screen. We're still on our alerts menu. You'll see we have 10 alerts, which are our new operators accounts that have been added. And again, if we select our action box for each of those, we can see details of each of the alerts that were triggered. These were the new users that were created as console users. If we're happy with them, we can simply close that alert and you'll see that we now have no active alerts on the system. Nice and simple and easy to use. Thank you for viewing this tour. Please visit www.netsupportdna.com to find out more, or if appropriate, download a free 30-day trial.